Hi everyone, this is Yumiko. In this webinar, I'm going to introduce you to the Action Plan Report. In the checklist, you can keep track of action items in several ways. In the main checklist view, in each content area tab, the status bar at the top lets you know how many incomplete, complete, action required, and critical items there are. And if you click on each category, you can see the status of each compliance item within that category. Remember, you also have the dashboard view, which shows the status of the entire program across all content areas. Now, the Action Plan Report, which you can access by going to this link, allows you to view at a glance not only which compliance items require action, but more detail as to what the action items actually are. So instead of having to scroll through the whole checklist to read individual action items, you can simply pull up this report to read through all action items in one place. Up at the top here, you have the option of viewing all action items, which is the default setting, or you can choose to only view critical action items, and you do this by deselecting the action required box. You could also choose to view the action required items only. You can also filter this report by content area. The default setting is to view all action items in all content areas, but you can select a particular content area via this drop-down menu. I'm going to select PDM. As you know, individual action items can be assigned to a particular staff person. This link here allows you to view those action items that have been assigned to you only. Now let's take a look at the body of the report. We see here that there are three compliance items with action required status in the communication and planning category within PDM. Under each compliance item, you will see the status of that compliance item, as well as this last status update that has been entered into the checklist. Finally, you'll see details of the actual action item. Remember, there may be more than one action item associated with each compliance item. If you are accessing the report online, the pencil icon allows you to navigate directly to the detailed edit page so that you can make updates or edits as needed. You also have the option to print this report, and you can do so by choosing the link in the upper left-hand corner. In summary, you should use the Action Plan Report to view action items at a glance for the entire program. I hope you find this report useful as you continue to monitor and work on action items for your program. Thanks for taking the time to view this video.